Hi, it's Katrina. From problematic papayas to not-so-sweet sugar that can hurt you, here are 10 foods that you didn't know were genetically modified. Number 10, cotton. Think cotton isn't a foodstuff? Think again. Sure, you can't chow down on cotton balls, but cotton seed has many other uses, including cattle feed. In fact, these Belgian blue cattle I'll mention soon probably have it for their dinner. However, use those seeds to make cottonseed oil, and that goes into cooking for humans. Cotton is one crop that's received the GM, or genetically modified, treatment. By being engineered this way, it undergoes a complex process where it resists certain herbicides and wipes out pests. No wonder GM is popular if it turns cotton into a kind of crop-based superhero with special powers. While it sounds wonderful, the reality brings you back down to earth, so to speak. As said by Jeff Goldblum in Jurassic Park, life finds a way. So in areas around the world where GM cotton was grown, pests adapted to the new conditions. Also, there was a reported health impact on farmers, so the science part is still being worked out. Number 9, dairy. If you weren't already getting a little bit uncomfortable, there are also GMOs, or genetically modified organisms, in dairy. Actually, it is a growth hormone that is injected into cows, which in turn create more milk. This practice is frowned upon around the world and is actually banned in most industrialized countries because it poses many health risks to the animals and to humans. But why is genetically modified milk a bad thing? Concerns have grown over the years over the notorious agrochemical company Monsanto. They engineered what's known as a recombinant bovine growth hormone. That's kind of a mouthful in more ways than one, so it's abbreviated to RBGH or RBST. The resulting milk reportedly contains unacceptable levels of the hormone IGF-1, which is said to increase the risk of many different cancers. Who knew milk could potentially be so dangerous, right? It's not a wonderful experience for the cow either. Aside from the factory farm conditions in some dairies that are a source of protest anyway, a big problem is a possible link to mastitis. That's where the udders become infected, and it's bad news for us too because pus can get in the milk supply. Ugh. The approval of RBGH in the United States is seen as very controversial, and Monsanto is plagued with toxic disasters, lawsuits, and cover-ups. The rest of us get contaminated milk, the cows suffer, and we have no clue all of this is going on. Just say no to drugs in your milk. Number 8. Honey. A genetically modified bee population sounds like something from a sci-fi movie, but it's already happened, people! In 2014, a team in Germany were investigating honeybees but needed to take their research to the next level, so they developed a new type of insect. Believe it or not, there's a lot we don't know about our stripy, stingy friends. Sure, there's a queen and they hang out in those hives in their thousands producing that sweet, sweet honey, but on the whole, our knowledge is actually pretty vague in terms of how their little minds work, and we are just learning how smart they really are. GMO is a major way of getting down to the nitty-gritty and building a comprehensive picture of bee society. By messing around with their DNA, we could make new strains of bee that can fight infections and overall be more productive. Meaning that they could resist these new strains of diseases and maybe even protect themselves against invasive wasps. And of course, make us some more honey. Number 7. Papaya. Genetically modified food is extremely controversial, and interfering with nature's way is always going to have detractors, putting it mildly. However, there is a major success story when it comes to GM, and that's to do with the papaya. Let's go back to the 1940s for the beginning of a terrifying tale. Well, a terrifying tale if you like papaya. An affliction called the papaya ring spot virus appeared in Hawaii, and its effects spread around the world. Those juicy, fragrant papayas were in danger of disappearing forever. Thankfully, science was there to lend a hand with the development of the rainbow papaya. This super dude of papayas fought off the virus and enabled the industry to continue. So if you're against GM as a rule, but love papayas, you've got a moral dilemma on your hands, I guess. Number 6. Potatoes. The process is still in its infancy, but genetic modification is coming to the humble potato. It's a versatile food that's given us so much, from creamy potato salad to crispy french fries. But this dirty little dude who comes out of the ground isn't perfect, and that's what scientists are hoping to address with GM. How about a potato that doesn't bruise or has a more attractive color? Tech known as RNAi, which basically involves interfering with genes and other things, is employed to make these refinements, and the result is a potato called the white russet. This is the only example of a GM potato to date, so we're not likely to see GM fries anytime soon. Of course, if you did want to make fries with a white russet, it could be better for your health. It keeps its white color when peeled and cut up, and the main selling point is that it produces lower levels of asparagine. What's that? It was first observed in asparagus juice, and if you fry a regular potato, it can become carcinogenic, which is bad news for your insides. The russet avoids that. As a side note, wait, who wants asparagus juice? Is that a new thing that's good for you? Maybe I missed something. Number 5. Soy beans. We associate soy with healthy eating and an alternative to things like dairy, so it may surprise you to learn that most of the soybeans in the US are GMOs. They're grown this way to make them tougher against herbicides, which makes sense, but is also controversial. Scientists have made a possible connection between this type of soy and liver problems, as well as fertility and even infant deaths. This is based on tests conducted on hamsters, not humans, but is pretty worrying, right? Especially for those poor hamsters. Plus, being able to fight off chemicals isn't always a good thing. It means the chemicals stay on the beans, and that goes into your system when you eat them. It's not like soy isn't in a whole lot of stuff we consume either. Not only is it in animal feed, but it's also in bread, cereal, even meat. Soy can be everywhere. Number 4. Sugar. Another popular ingredient in all types of food is sugar, and much of US sugar is subject to genetic modification. Monsanto, that company again, created a sugar beet in 2005 that was resistant against its own weed killer. Now, this caused a lot of concern, as reportedly GMO products are not sufficiently tested, and authorities are apparently not that worried about letting Monsanto release their sugar beet for general consumption. It all appears to be a done deal, which is frightening if there are any health risks because sugar is in everything. As I've mentioned before, the best way to handle this situation is to educate yourself and ask important questions. Do we need GMOs to play God and protect nature against diseases and wipeouts? Are we comfortable with big companies seemingly not being accountable? On the flip side, are GMOs really as bad as people think? Let me know in the comments below. Question everything, especially if you're putting it in your mouth. Number 3. Tobacco. I know what you're thinking. Tobacco? Don't you smoke it rather than eat it? Well, yeah, you smoke tobacco, but it can also be used as an ingredient in cooking. Plus, you can chew it, though I don't know who does that anymore. Maybe if you're an old-time cowboy or something. Also, what do you think you're doing when you take tobacco smoke into your lungs? Your body absorbs what's in the plant the way your stomach takes in food. Anyway, the point is tobacco makes an interesting addition to this list because of the high genetically modified content that goes into its production. Even though I say interesting, I actually mean unsettling, because of the nicotine naturally, but also the other things inside that brown, crinkly stuff. A reported 90% of tobacco is produced using GMOs. That means while the GM tobacco is resistant to bugs, it also contains around 4,000 chemicals which are used for pesticides and herbicides. These noxious substances are what you crave when waiting for your next death stick. So if you've been thinking of quitting smoking or chewing or whatever it is that you do, now is the time to bite the bullet and quit. Number 2. Yeast. Yeast is a key element of bread production and beer and wine fermentation. Genetic tinkering has become a part of yeast production also, as with lots of other foods. However, this could be a good thing, as a super yeast has the potential to make that alcohol healthier, and best of all, may reduce hangovers. This new genetically modified yeast can boost the health benefits of wine. Thing is, yeast is a tough nut to crack, with scientists developing intricate ways of altering genes to boost the amount of things like resveratrol. Resveratrol is a compound found in red wine which acts as an antioxidant and anti-inflammatory. These studies can help us learn which bits of DNA are responsible for what taste. That doesn't mean you should go out and drink more wine, by the way, but you can if you want to. Number 1. Beef. What's a good way of getting more meat from a poor, unsuspecting cow? Breeding a super cow, of course. If you haven't seen a Belgian Blue or Piedmontese cattle before, then prepare to be shocked. These animals have got more bulging biceps than a hug between Arnold Schwarzenegger and Sylvester Stallone. The idea is that by utilizing the breed's increased muscle mass, known as double muscling, you obtain more high-quality meat. Sinister for sure, but delicious. which is why the Belgian Blue, for example, has been farmed for over 100 years. Because of a genetic mutation, the cow inhibits the flow of myostatin, which is a growth hormone to do with muscle fibers. A lack of myostatin leads to more fibers and some pretty big bovines. Note that I said genetic mutation. The double muscling is a combo of natural development and selective breeding by enterprising farmers that's been taking place since the food shortages of World War II. There's no genetic modification involved in an official sense, though it is tempting to look at these cows in a crazy sci-fi type of way. Thanks for watching! Are there any surprise genetically modified foods left off the list? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe and I'll see you next time. Bye!